but I know they'll never own me. Welcome to today's video. I can't talk too loud because I'm still echoing in here. By the way, it is almost time for a finished house tour, you guys. But I ordered one more piece of furniture and it comes on March 1st. So I really just want to wait until I have everything and then show you guys. So just bear with me. And I'm trying to get the Amazon page kind of sorted out. But I do have a bunch of furniture from like Wayfair and stuff. I'll make sure that I link it when I do that video. But today's video is obviously not a house tour. It is a shoulder workout. I wanted it to be completely different than anything I've ever done before. I just went into the gym and I was like, let's do some fancy stuff. So totally switched it up, did some new exercises that you guys are gonna see here. I hope that you enjoy it. If you give it a try, don't forget that everything is written down in the description box for you just to screenshot and try on your own. Then you gotta come back and let me know what you think because I love to hear from you guys. So hope that you enjoy this shoulder and ab workout. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I will catch you in the next one, which is gonna be a full day of eating. Bye, guys.
Do you guys want your shoulders to already be sore after you're finished your workout, like moments later? Because if you do, you came to the right place. I chose 8 different exercises, some that are traditional and some that I haven't done for a while, and I combined them in to this workout. So what we're gonna be doing here is a couple different supersets. Every single exercise is superset, and there's gonna be little to no rest in between until you finish both exercises. So let's get into superset numero 1. I wish I could speak a different language. The first exercise is lateral raises with some double lateral raise. Believe it or not, but that is one exercise, even though there is 2 exercises in one. I know, right? And then we're gonna superset that with some single arm Arnold shoulder press. You're gonna be doing that 3 times through and move on to circuit number 2. This is a little number that I learned actually a couple years ago during competition prep while I was training at one of the most infamous gyms that there is in North America, the Mecca. So I was training for the Arnold and this trainer came over to me and told me to do this exercise and it stuck with me ever since and it is incredibly hard. So you grab an easy barbell or a regular barbell and you do a over the head front raise and then you do a half front raise and that is 1 rep. So you're gonna go overhead, do the half and then all the way back down and then do it 10 times through. Then I did that with some seated dumbbell shoulder press. So I really made sure to pay attention to the tempo here. I was doing 3 counts down, 1 count up. I was only able to do 10 to 12 of them. They're absolutely killer. You guys, I cannot stress enough how important tempo is. If you're just going through the movements and trying to get it done as fast as possible, you're not working your muscles to the best of their ability. You're not really getting in a good mind-to-muscle connection there. Trust me. Focus on that tempo. Play with different tempos like 3 counts down, 1 count up, 3 counts down, 3 counts up, and it'll be a whole other ballgame. Then we're moving on to circuit number 3. This is a front raise with static hold. So, oh my God, it hurts so bad. You hold the other arm out in front of you and you do 10 raises with the opposite arm and then you alternate. It totally kills. And then I went into these little like circles. So I dropped the weight here and I'm doing 5 pounds. And what I want you to do is make big circles and then smaller circles and just keep rotating. Try to do 20 of those. I learned that in a spin class. It hurts real good. Moving on to some rear delts. I actually have never done this exercise before. The girls always get in the way, if you know what I mean. But I wanted to give it a try. So we did some lighter weight. I think I was doing 8 pounds here just to make sure that I was getting the form down right. And I felt it exactly where I needed to, which was in the rear delts. Make sure that you keep the neck neutral with the spine, because as soon as you bring your head up, you're straining the neck and you're taking the focus away from the rear delts. And then to finish it off, I did some barbell clean and press. And this was actually the first set that I did of this, but for the second and third, I actually added in a press at the top. So it's a barbell clean and press, and then I added in an extra press, and it was totally killer. I recorded that for Instagram, so if you're not already following me there, shameless plug, but even the regular clean and press absolutely kills as well. And I love to finish off shoulder or upper body workouts with clean and press because it's just a really great burnout exercise.
Oh, I actually do want to possibly do a Q&A as well. So now that you're finished watching this video, if you guys want me to do a Q&A, then comment your questions down below and we'll get a Q&A rolling. Bye guys, hope that you have an awesome day, awesome night, wherever you are in the world. I will see you in the next video. Cap in a stem, catch a wave on us. Take a shot, make a friend, just enjoy.